All right, very great. The crickets are chirping. It's a wonderful evening, May 30th, 2012. It's time to continue to speak up. I tried to record a video earlier and I was so tired I fell asleep. It's not really tiredness, it's something else, stress, I guess you call it, because we really are starting to venture into the abyss right now. It's very, very powerful. I know many are feeling it. But what better time to throw some clarity on what the remedy really is? As I've said before, it's to choose a new idea and to experience the effect of that idea, which is like a perfect mirror to what we really are. And so we need to continue to focus on that as the train wreck begins to really get severe right now. As it is, as it really is, there are heading into June. We made it this far, May 30th, 2012, which is quite an accomplishment. And we need to make it even further. And in order to do that, we'd really have to have some tools to utilize and actually use them. We cannot just simply keep looking at the world and relying on time to be the tool that we use. By that I mean, we cannot say, well, you know, Spain is imploding today, but tomorrow, let's see what tomorrow will bring. Or go into memory. Oh, I remember when things were better with Spain. So that's called using time. You either focus on the past or on the future, because right now it's terrible. And that will not work for us very well right now. So what I would like to do and suggest is to, instead of using time, step away from time and say that what is happening right now is not affecting the overlay. The overlay is not collapsing. The overlay doesn't need tomorrow. The overlay doesn't need yesterday. It's stable right now, perfectly stable. And so that perfect mirror of what we are, which is the effect of not trying to be prime creator, that perfect mirror is not collapsing. It is not imploding. It's not in debt. So we look at that, focus our attention on that instead of on time. Our tendency is to focus on time, because the mind will say, well, what's going to happen tomorrow? Maybe it'll be better tomorrow, right? That's what hooks us. We get hooked and we think, well, you know, yeah, everything is awful, but there's sure to be some kind of bounce back tomorrow. So let's stay focused on it and wait it out, and we'll see what tomorrow brings. That's not the solution right now. In fact, that's what will pull you into the abyss, is to continue to focus on what's taking place, thinking that there's some remedy in time. It'll only get worse and worse and worse, and we'll keep going. No matter how bad it gets, we get so stressed out, we say, well, it just this can't keep going. Tomorrow must be better. And it gets worse. And we've already been through that. It's been almost a year. I think it was starting in July of last year. It could have been June. I'll have to go back and look at my other channel, Clarity Ross, and see when I started posting on this, saying the instability was what the underpinnings of the red flags we would start to notice. The harbingers of the collapse were going to be very noticeable, and they were. That was a very accurate prediction. So we've gone through a year of it, but we keep thinking tomorrow's going to be better. Tomorrow's going to be better. And really, we've been dragged through so much stress by doing that, by hoping that there's going to be a remedy headed our way if we just wait for it. And it doesn't seem to be happening. In fact, it definitely is not happening. So, what the remedy would be, again, is to choose a new idea and experience that which is not collapsing, which cannot collapse, because it's everywhere, perfectly still. And to look at that and say, is that collapsing? And do we need time? Do we need to look at the future of that? You see, our habit is so much based on tomorrow. You know, tomorrow, tomorrow. It'll be better tomorrow. So whatever happens, time heals all wounds, we think. So we just need to wait till tomorrow. And we're so used to that, that when we see, experience still this, the pure stillness that is present right now, we tend to automatically think about tomorrow, what's going to be like tomorrow. And when we don't see any tomorrow, we get nervous because we equate tomorrow with better, getting better. And if we don't have some hope for getting better, we assume that things will get, you know, worse or things are bad. So we lay that interpretation, assumption onto the stillness, but it's not really there. Because there is no getting better or getting worse for that. It's like a perfect mirror. The mirror doesn't get better or worse. The mirror just reflects accurately, and the reflection will be entirely accurate tomorrow, and the next day, it doesn't need to get better. So it's a whole different situation. It's not a time-based situation of tomorrow getting better. The situation of right now, it's perfectly unaffected. And tomorrow it will be perfectly unaffected, and yesterday it was perfectly unaffected. So it's like a timeless type of situation. So we need to shift from time-based expectations to timeless-based expectations. And that will literally cause us to cruise through these times unscathed. And of course, we've all heard this before. Ad infinitum. And yet we don't do it. We haven't done it yet. Which all that means is that we have to focus on a little more. A little more willingness. So that we actually do it. And maybe the explanation, the clarification here, it will chip away at that reluctance, erode it significantly. As I've said, we have these expectations, time-based expectations, that we assume that today is not going to be that great, but tomorrow will be better. And if we don't see it tomorrow, don't sense a change taking place, it scares us. We think, uh-oh, we're going to be stuck with what we have, which isn't so good. So when we look at the perfect stillness that is present right now, as the effect of the idea of not trying to be prime creator, we don't see it getting better. We don't see a tomorrow there. And so we assume that it's not going to feel good. It's not going to be good. It's just an assumption based on what we experience with time. With the effect of trying to be prime creator and the impermanence of that and the misery of that, we are always expecting it to get better. I better turn on my mosquito repellent here. So we're all expecting tomorrow to be better, and if we don't see any tomorrow, then we start to panic and say, we're going to be stuck with what we have right now, and what we have right now is not good. Can't be good. It's never been good. It's never really been that good. We have to have a tomorrow. We always have to have a sense of moving forward and moving forward. You notice that in existence? If we were told that existence, we'll be stuck with what we have right now. If we were told that, what would our reaction be? We would freak out, right? If we were told that what we have is never going to improve right now, if what we have right now is never going to improve, we would absolutely freak out. I think you can agree with that. I think we can all agree with that. That's what I know. I certainly would. If I said I'm going to feel just the way I feel right now, if I'm going to always feel that way, oh boy, you know, that could not tolerate that. So the belief we have is that tomorrow is going to be better. We're going to see an improvement. Now, when we experience the stillness that is present right now, the perfect stillness, the perfect peace that is present right now, we don't see that it's going to get any better. We don't see any change. We don't see a tomorrow. We don't see a process. There's no process. There's no sleep from it, in it. And so we say, this is not going to get any better. It's not going to change. If there's no change, how can it get better, right? And so we just assume that that's a horrible thing. We're just assuming, oh my gosh, that's a horrible, terrible thing. It's not going to change. That means it can't get any better, right? So you can see how we're spooked. We're spooked about it. And these are things we have to clarify in order to actually choose to experience this. But you see, the whole point of the perfect stillness that is present right now is that to remind us of what we are, which doesn't change. What we are doesn't change. It's perfectly stable. It's invulnerable to modification. So we need to be reminded of that. And the perfect stillness doesn't need to change to be wonderfully blissful for us. But we kind of use the formula of we need change to make things better. That's kind of the formula that we are using. We need change to make things better. And so seeing that which doesn't change is going to freak us out. We're going to say, we need some change. I got to jump back into change. That's the only hope I have of feeling better. But in feeling the perfect stillness, we don't need to feel any better. Because it's not tired. It's not unstable. It's not vulnerable. It's not being modified into something else. So we don't need for it to change. So these are issues that I'm seeing. I'm just looking at the situation and seeing what is it that prevents us from really meeting the challenges of the times right now, which would be to experience this, that which doesn't change at all. And it what shows up is that we associate change with hope. Hope that things will feel better. And if we don't have change, we associate that with no hope, hopelessness, assuming that we need to feel better. But the perfect stillness feels perfect. So there's no need to change it. That's the testimony of those who have felt this. Is that it's there's no desire to change it. So we don't really need any change to take place. Obviously, the world, we will have great desire for tomorrows to take place, right? For instance, the financial troubles and crises, and you can mention that to people, and they will say, yeah, it is probably going to be really bad for a while, but, you know, eventually it'll smooth out. Okay, that's putting hope in time. What if it doesn't smooth out? Or maybe by the time it smooths out, the stress will have got to us too severely. It's already gotten to me too severely. Just feeling the bounce back from the future, horrible bounce back of what's to come, it's already gotten to me. So the more sensitive you are towards the future, and the more of the bounce back you feel, like the echo, it's like you shout. And you get an echo bouncing back, and you get a feeling of what's going on. They use a lot of sonar now, a lot of ways of using sound to determine what's going on under the ground and all sorts of places. In concrete, for instance, they want to see if the concrete has set properly, and they'll run a sound test through the concrete, and depending on the bounce back that they get from that, for instance, on the Bay Bridge here in from San Francisco to Oakland, they're basically building a new bridge, and has to withstand severe earthquakes. And so they test the concrete that they've poured to make sure it's hardened properly by using sound and bouncing sound through it somehow. Vibration, I guess. And then from the feedback they get from that, they can determine whether it's set properly or not. Well, the same thing about the future. You can somehow send vibrations into the future, as it were. As if the future were like something distant. For instance, let's say you're in a canyon and you shout, and the vibration travels through the air and hits the canyon walls, and eventually it bounces back to you as an echo. And so you're literally getting a sounding from what's up ahead. The same way, in a similar way, you can get a sounding from what's up ahead with this planet. And when you do get that bounce back, you can evaluate it. And if it's a kind of a scary bounce back, you say, uh-oh, boy, that's terrible. Whereas if it's a beautiful bounce back, you say, ah, I think things are going to be really great coming up. Now, those who don't shout into the future don't get a bounce back. So they may say, well, we don't know. I don't know. I have no idea. But those who do project into the future and get a bounce back, then they can be aware of what's going on. And for me, I'm getting the bounce back from the future right now. And it's terrible. In fact, it's like a black hole. You know, there is no bounce back, almost, as it were. So tomorrow may not solve the problems of today. Again, what if we were stuck with today? Or what if things are actually going to get worse and worse and worse, and we're just stuck with that? Then time doesn't work for us anymore. We're really running into a situation where time won't work for us anymore. Crucial to hear that. It's almost like we're running into a black hole. Things don't get better in a black hole. Doesn't improve. So, as some have said, it's the Kali Yuga. It's the time of destruction, the dance of destruction. It's the time of collapse of civilizations, collapse of worlds. Things don't get better. You know, you can say, well, eventually they get different. Another cycle has started. But one could also say that starting another cycle is the booby prize. And certainly, getting through the end of this cycle is more than problematical. So it's crucial to step out of time. And we're starting, more than starting, we're getting our fingers on what it just means. We're getting a grasp of it. That's a wonderful thing. Very positive. And it's not that we're looking to tomorrow. We're looking to step out of time and experience that which doesn't change, doesn't need time to get better. It's perfect right now. Perfect right now. If we felt experience what was perfect right now, why would we put our stock in tomorrow? Right? Why would we say, well, it's perfect right now, but we know it's going to be better tomorrow. So, would we say that? No, we'd say, ah, I just want to experience this right now because it's perfect. I don't care about some kind of any change. In other words, tomorrow implying change. Don't need it. Don't need it. I don't need yesterday either. Right? Don't need yesterday. I don't need to remember what was before this effect. Right? I don't need to remember what was before the perfect peace that is present right now. I don't need to remember before that. I don't need to go in the past. Because there's nothing wrong. It's perfect. It feels perfect. So why do I need to think, well, what was it like before I felt this? And I felt all the stress. What was it like? No. So we don't need to remember how it felt in the past. And we don't need to project how it may feel in the future, because it's perfect right now. That's called the timeless. We're stepping out of time. It may be a lot easier than we suspect. For some reason, we just haven't been able to focus on doing it. There are some that have done this, no question about it. But we're here under these circumstances right now, and we have to do it now. We have to stop believing in tomorrow right now. The reason why it's a challenge for us is because we have so much technology now that we have been seduced into believing that it will make a better tomorrow for us. Okay? And it may not do that. In fact, it may make it worse tomorrow. Technology. If you put it to people in the world right now, what's going to happen? And you say, well, it's looking real bad, and they may agree. And they say, yeah, but it'll be fixed. You know, we have ways to deal with it. There are ways to deal with it. There's a confidence in tomorrow. I believe it's a misplaced confidence. In fact, things are going to get worse tomorrow, not better. The contagion will spread. The house of cards is going to collapse. We've been kicking the can down the road. Basically, what we've been doing is we've been trying to say, well, if we can just postpone this collapse until after I die, then, you know, that's good enough for me. And that's been going on for a long time, actually. And those who are younger, they're hoping, you know, we just have to keep this going, you know, until I get through my life. And then, you know, maybe it'll collapse then. Kicking the can down the road. And we've done it for so long that we can't really do it any longer. We can't keep putting our faith in time. And so our challenge is to step back out of time and accept the timeless. It's a question of accepting it. Accept the timeless. And whoever does that is always welcome here. We'll be welcome in many places, that's for sure. I'll put you on this channel. We'll do a video. Whoever has stepped out of time, that's the one that is valuable right now, believe me. I can tell you this, I give you this 100% assurance. Those who have stepped out of time are of enormous value to the world, to you, to me, to everyone right now. They need to come forward. We need to put them up on YouTube. They need to be seen because they carry the key. They're showing us the remedy, stepping out of time. It's not that difficult based on what we've talked about here in this video. It's really not that difficult. It's just our only trouble really is that we have expectations of time and we apply them to the timeless and draw a false conclusion. Because it doesn't change, we automatically assume we're going to be stuck with something that doesn't feel very good. You see, so we don't go there. That's a false assumption, isn't it? If we can just work that through, get a little help right now, I'm convinced that we can step out of time. And I'm positive that is what has to be done right now. Absolutely imperative. You cannot continue to put your faith in time as we go forward. Now, that's what 2012 is all about, is stepping out of time. That is the challenge. That is the goal. We have a goal, simply to step out of time, meaning to experience the effect, the perfect peace that is present right now. And we have a set of expectations that go along with time, and we need to realize how this set of expectations frightens us away from the timeless, because we put our faith in change. We put our faith in tomorrow. We put our faith in getting better and improvement. And if we see something that isn't changing, isn't improving, isn't getting better, we automatically assume we're going to get stuck in something that we can't stand. And once again, I don't know of anyone who would say truthfully that they want to be stuck right where they are and not change at all. I think everyone would say, no. I want to feel better than I feel right now. I don't want to be stuck with this. So we have this horror of being stuck, and we look at the timeless and this perfect peace that is present right now, the perfect stillness that is present right now and always present exactly like this. And we see it's not changing. We feel like this is it. And we assume that being stuck in this is a bad thing. We just equate a lack of change with being stuck in something that feels bad. And so we don't even try the timeless. We just automatically reject it because we say, well, I'm smart enough to see that it can't possibly be good for me. But we leave out the possibility that what is perfect and flawless and unchanging and reflects what we are is actually a perfect feeling, and that we would not want to change a perfect feeling, and therefore we're not stuck, we're simply abiding in it. Because we could choose to jump back into time if we wanted to and experience all that change, but we don't need to, because we're satisfied. If we're really satisfied, we've never experienced being truly satisfied, so we just don't think that such a state exists. And so therefore we assume that we must have some capacity to change whatever is taking place. We have to feel we have capacity to change it. But the whole purpose of the perfect peace beyond understanding that is present right now is that it doesn't change. You can't change it. And we're frightened of that. We want to feel some capability to change. That's right. That's what time is all about. As we look at our environment, I look out here and I say, well, everything I see, I know I can change it. Everything. The stone, the brick, the concrete, the plants, all the plants, the landscape, the house, the lighting, you name it. Everything, right? We can change it. We feel, we look out upon the world, there's nothing that we see that we don't know that we could make a change in that. Sometimes even people scrawl graffiti on you know, freeways and stuff like that, because they're saying, hey, look, I can change this. I can make it different. We can even change the ocean, which we have been doing, right? Ruining it. But we're changing it. We're changing everything on the planet. So we are completely geared towards change, our capacity to change things. And yet the perfect peace beyond understanding can't be changed. It's a seamless oneness. There's nothing to change. You cannot fragment it. You cannot change it. And so we feel that the lack of that capability to change it equates us to being stuck in a terrible situation, an unpleasant situation. Automatically assume it. So at least we've identified what the problem is, that the practical problem we have. And if we just, you know, hear this, I must say, oh, okay, there is a dynamic, there is an actual mistake that we're making. It's not that it's difficult, it's that we're simply assuming that it won't be palatable for us. That's really the problem. And yet, what happens is we are also assuming that it's difficult to do. We're assuming that it's really difficult. The reason why we're not doing it is because it's so difficult. It must be difficult. Why else would we not be doing it? Well, the other explanation would be because we're making a mistake. We're making a mistaken assumption. Applying the dynamics of time to the timeless, which is a mistake. So this is really good news. This is the gospel. The gospel means the good news. And so we're the satsang is laying out the gospel, laying out the good news that we can step out of time into the timeless, because we can stop misapplying the expectations of time to the timeless. I mean, conversely, we would not apply what applies to the timeless to time, right? We wouldn't come into time and say, well, we don't need to change anything. We're just going to keep everything exactly the same. We wouldn't do that. That would be stupid, because we don't feel good. We want to change things. We want to try. We have to keep trying to feel better, because we're not satisfied at all. And so to assert that we're just going to get stuck with what we have right now, that'd be crazy. That'd be a mistake to do that. Conversely, it's a mistake to apply those parameters to the timeless, which is already perfect, which is already flawless, which already feels totally satisfying, which brings peace beyond understanding. We don't need to change that. We don't need to be afraid of being stuck in it. It's like we get into a cold shower, a very freezing shower, and we say, oh, I want to get out of here. I want to change the water temperature. And let's say if we get into a shower that's just the perfect temperature, and we just say, I don't want to touch that temperature. It's just right. It's like that. The experience of perfect peace that is present right now is just right. Don't want to change it. So stepping out of time is what will save us going forward. And we have to do it soon, which is why I'm calling out all those who have stepped out of time to contribute. Don't hide your light under a bushel basket. Don't hide it. Because everyone needs to get clued into this. Everybody. Everyone has to step out of time. Those who don't are really, really in for more than they bargained for. It's no time to adopt an attitude that either a macho attitude or a multitasking attitude. You know, like, I can tough this out. That's a macho attitude. And or the other attitude would be, well, I'm so flexible and capable of multitasking so well that I'm sure I can, manage to thread my way through this and bend with the wind and get through it. No. Both of those attitudes will end up bringing about enormous misery. There's no way around this one. There's no way through this one. One has to step out of time. We have to drop the various strategies that we've been using in time. Some is, just to tough it out. Say, hey, I'll just deal with what I'm feeling right now and just hope I feel better tomorrow. And others will say, I'll be able to manipulate everything so artfully in my environment. I'm so good at manipulation and multitasking that I'll be able to get through this. Not true. Not true. Those are the attitudes which will bring ruination. So both of those attitudes, typically those attitudes are just generalized as male and female attitudes. Both of those attitudes will completely fail. So it's a failure of all time-based attitudes. Doesn't matter who's having them, what age, what gender, doesn't matter. All time-based attitudes will fail, will lead one into collapse. Only stepping out of time works. So we need those who have stepped out of time to step forward. I'm doing my part right now. by clarifying, which is what I'm good at. Couple that with those who stepped out of time, it's a good combination, because I can pinpoint what the problem really is, as this video has done, and highlight it and say, you know what, it's really not as difficult as we think. It's just kind of a simple mistake we're making, a simple assumption. But there again, we need someone who has done it, and we can look at that and get assurance from that. You know, just ask them, hey, you know, it's good. And they say, yeah, it's great, no problem. It's like that. And we need many, 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 many of those who have stepped out of time. Whoever steps out of time needs to step forward. It is literally the prescription, the RX for these times. It is the cure for these times. Literally is the cure. I've been working on a cure for these times my whole life. And now I'm seeing this is the cure. Stepping out of time is the cure. And I know there's many others who have seen this too. Been working in the same direction and saying basically the same thing. But each one has to see it for themselves. It's not like I'm parroting anybody. This is just spontaneously coming from my own seeing. We can step out of time. We must step out of time. We have to do it. We have to do it soon. We cannot keep relying on tomorrow. Because tomorrow doesn't love us. That's for sure. We are not loved by tomorrow. We can't manipulate a black hole, so to speak. Those kind of strategies will come up short. And I know that there are many who, out of pride, spiritual pride and bad karma they've accumulated, will believe that, you know, they need to just rise to the occasion and manipulate things even more cleverly, or simply be even tougher, tough it out, you know, just take the pain, just, you know, no matter what pain. You know, instead of eating one hot pepper, eat 10 of them. You know, that's not a good idea. I mean, at a certain point, eat too many super hot peppers, you're going to get really sick. And at some point, you can't tough it out anymore. There's limits. And there are those who will say, well, yeah, I'm going to eat the hot pepper, and they think they can manipulate their way out of doing it. But I tell you, the future is like a very hot pepper. 2 million Scoville units. Maybe 10 million Scoville units. Let's put it at 10 million Scoville units. The future. It's like that. Who can eat that pepper without throwing up? Nobody. It doesn't matter how much milk you drink. That pepper is going to bust you up. It's going to bring you down. That pepper is just too hot to eat. The future is the hottest pepper there ever was. And it's all in time. It's time. So we have to step out of time. I wonder if that mosquito thing is working or not. It seems like no mosquitoes are coming for me. Maybe I better. I'm trying to avoid them. Yeah. I've been watching some of those hot pepper videos on YouTube. Very funny, but really, you realize that you can reach a point where you can't tolerate anymore. There's only so much we can tolerate. And everyone has a breaking point. The world, the time is going to break us right now. We're headed for the breaking point. And so one has to employ wisdom. You know, I'm not stupid enough to eat a hot pepper. I know it'll bust me up. Forget it. Maybe when I was younger, I would have, no question about it, but not now. And so, you know, sometimes the folly of youth gets in the way, thinking that it's bulletproof, but you get older and you realize, no, that's just stupid. The future is extreme ghost pepper. And don't be folly like, hey, I'm going to be the one that can handle that pepper, because the Scoville units are completely off any chart. Whole body will turn into fire, spontaneous combustion if you eat that pepper. So let's not do that. Let's instead step out of time. There, it's all cool. Perfect coolness. You know, if we want to be cool, step out of time. You hear every generation uses the same kind of, allude to the same thing. You know, this is cool. You know, doing this is cool. There's various things that are cool. Basically, there are things that, like, harm you, but, you know, drinking too much, you know, doing radical stuff, dangerous stuff. They say, when you're young, you say, yeah, that's really cool. Yeah, that we can, you know, get on the edge like that. But the edge of the future is too sharp. It's not cool. But stepping out of time is really cool. It's perfectly cool. It's the perfectly cool thing to do. It's just right. Yeah, there's no danger to it, no edge to it. But having no edge to it is really cool. Experiencing no edginess is the ultimate in coolness. Experiencing just the right temperature is just right. We have to change our attitudes about this. That's why spiritual teaching put a lot of respect into older people, because they're not controlled by the folly of youth as much anymore. The folly of youth likes to put itself through challenges and find edges and danger and extricate itself from danger. That's just, you know, that's what happens. And but this time, that's foolish. That's crazy. It's really insane to do that right now. At some point, one has to point out that it's insane. There are certain things you just don't do. And what you don't do right now is don't put your faith in time. That's a mark of insanity. Not a mark of bravery or of cleverness. There are some who are not so brave, but they're very clever. They know how to manipulate others. And they figure that they can just manipulate others enough that they can then get through these times that are coming. Not true. Because the very ones they're trying to manipulate, they're going to fall by the wayside too. And they'll be left with no one to manipulate. They have to deal with it themselves. Then what will they do? Right? So step out of time. Pay attention to stepping out of time. We're bringing the clarification here on this channel. And we're calling on those who have stepped out of time to step forward now. I'll put them on this channel. I'll interview them. I'll videotape them. I'll audio tape them. I'll post it right here on this channel. It's time for those who have stepped out of time to make a timely entrance. I really believe it's going to happen. It has to happen. Let's say June 1st. June 1st. Let's expect it. Let's say that is, you know, what was this? 67 was the summer of love. What is this summer? The summer of timelessness. The summer of stepping out of time. The timeless summer. Let's call it that. There's a surf movie called The Endless Summer. Let's call this the timeless summer. Yeah, maybe I should make a channel called The Timeless Summer. Let's do it. Let's make this the timeless summer. That should be a goal. We can do it. I mean, the summer of love happened, I know, because I was up there, at least on one occasion in San Francisco. Went through Haight-Ashbury. It was absolutely unbelievable. I mean, it's like we went to another planet. I remember we drove through, my parents were driving, we drove through Haight-Ashbury. Holy cow. I mean, you go from a very calm suburban world into the middle of the summer of love. I mean, that was an eye opener, jaw dropper. But that's long gone. But we're going to make this summer the summer of timelessness, the timeless summer. We'll make 2012 the timeless summer. Let's get into it. I've got my video camera. Got to get the intent going here. We got to get it rolling. This is it. This is not a rehearsal anymore. We're past the rehearsal stage now, where we are on stage. You know, we're on the Grand Ole Opry. You know, the people are there. We've got to step up to the mic and say, howdy, folks. Great to be here at the Grand Ole Opry. I've always wondered what it's like to be here. Now we're here, and we're going to do some great music for you. And the first one we like, the song we like to do is, and then step into it. Have a good time. Get into the groove. We're not trying to replicate any other time. That's the past. We're not trying to replicate any time. We're trying to step out of time. So once again, I'm calling on any and all of those who have stepped out of time to step forward and help us out. Go on camera. Go on camera. Let it be known. Say, here I am. I'm sure there are those who have come into the world for the purpose of showing that they've stepped out of time. I'm sure there must be those, because all this has been foreseen, all of it. And it certainly has been foreseen that this summer of 2012 is the timeless summer. Has to be. We have to get it now. Have to get it. So it has got to be 100% for certain that there are those that will step forward now. Has to be. Because it's not that difficult. It's not that difficult to see through. It's guaranteed that there are some who have seen through it. Because we're seeing through it right now. And these videos, we've seen through it, and we're seeing that, hey, there is just this very simple addiction to time that is also very easily seen through. So there must be those who have seen through it for sure. And absolutely have seen through it. And it's time to get them up on the stage. You know, the audience will grow. No question about it. Word of mouth. I remember the Grateful Dead was playing for, you know, a few people. They had a house there in Haight-Ashbury, and they're playing for some friends, basically. And then, you know, they'd bring some more friends and family, and, you know, gradually a little audience gathered around them, and we'd go down Golden Gate Park, and we'd play there. And people would congregate there, and gradually it built and built and built. It's like that. The audience starts out small. Word of mouth, it spreads. And before you know it, it's a happening. It's the timeless summer. Before you know it, it's the timeless summer. just have to find the band members, so to speak. Put the band together. The timeless band. The band of timelessness. Just has to be put together right now. Show up, start singing some songs. So, that's what we have to look forward to. That's what I'm aiming towards, because in my mind it's crystal clear. We must step out of time. And it's not nearly as difficult as we think it is, and we actually can do it. Pretty darn simple, actually. It's not a complicated thing at all. It's just kind of it's that simple, huh? Wow. I didn't realize it was that simple. Just don't misapply the expectations of time onto timelessness. It's that simple. I'm sure at some point we'll look back and say, my gosh, that was easy. And yet right now we're scratching our heads and saying, you know, I don't know if we can do it. But we've got to do it. Now, I could be going to the U.S. Open here at the Olympic Club in San Francisco coming up in a couple weeks, but didn't get tickets, because I feel there's something else that's going to take place that's more important. And I must really, really believe that something very important will take place, otherwise, for sure, I would be going to watch the U.S. Open. That's like, for me, that'd be like the premier sporting event right here. Be able to go to the Olympic Club and watch the best golf, you know, in the world. It would be fabulous. But I'm saying, you know what? No. I believe that something else more profound is going to take place. And this is coming up in a couple weeks. Just a couple weeks from now. I think it starts like July 11th or something. I don't know. Just a couple weeks from now. We need to focus on timelessness right now, stepping out of time. Going to a golf tournament, you know, that's just basically trying to make things better in time. Say, well, tomorrow's gonna be a better day because I'm going to see the U.S. Open. So it's bound to be a better day. And then you go that and you feel tired and it's not so great. And you think, well, the memories of the U.S. Open will make tomorrow a better day. So that's still very much putting your faith in time to do that. And I'm putting my faith in timelessness, so. Let's have the real players get on the course. Maybe the players who are great at the course, meaning maybe A Course in Miracles, which certainly points towards stepping out of time. The players that can really play, those are the ones who have stepped out of time. Those are ones who really know the game and how to really play it. And how to ace the hole, you know, how to really ace it, how to shoot under par. Because the golf course, the future is going to be very different. If the future was a golf course, it would be, you know, the toughest golf course ever. It'd be impossible to play. You know, it's possible to make a golf course so difficult you can't even play it. And that's what the future is like. It doesn't matter how great a golfer you are, you can't play it. I mean, the greens are like, you know, vertical. Like, what can you do? It just becomes impossibly difficult to post any kind of score. Just ridiculous. It'll be like that. Don't want to play that course. Doesn't matter what kind of golfer you are. Forget it. You know, at some point you have to say, forget it. And of course, watching the U.S. Open is a very difficult course. What you see is very, very skilled people conquering that difficulty, and that gives us hope. But that's a false hope right now. We don't want that. Because the future will be too difficult to conquer. It's unconquerable. And this planet is unconquerable. So the thing to do is not look at skill in navigating through a difficult situation. What to look at is those who have stepped out of time into the timeless. That's the real play. That's the hole-in-one. That's the ace. So, here we go. We're right on the cusp right now. We're actually now, we're revving up and we're starting to move. Starting to move. This video is a video that is moving things forward now. Not so much in time, but moving towards stepping out of time. All right. We will end this video now. And look forward to what is to come during the timeless summer.